All right, so we see here in 2 Samuel 13, so then another question we have is, you know, people ask, do babies go to heaven when they die? And obviously we know the answer to that is yes, but we're trying to understand why that's the case. We just go here to 2 Samuel 12, it says here in verse 13, and David said unto Nathan, I have sinned against the Lord. So just so you get the context of this passage, Nathan has just come to David after he's committed adultery with Bathsheba and killed Uriah the Hittite. And Nathan has come and given him that parable about the traveler, the rich man that took this other guy's lamb and used it instead of his own from his own flock. And now has told him, you know, thou art the man. David is actually the person in that parable. And now in verse 13, he says, and David said unto Nathan, I have sinned against the Lord. And Nathan said unto David, the Lord also hath put away thy sin. Thou shalt not die. Howbeit, because by this deed thou hast given great occasion to the enemies of the Lord to blaspheme, the child also that is born unto thee shall surely die. And Nathan departed unto his house, and the Lord struck the child that Uriah's wife bare unto David, and it was very sick. David therefore besought God for the child, and David fasted and went in and lay all night upon the earth. And the elders of his house arose and went to him to raise him up from the earth, but he would not, neither did he eat bread with them. And it came to pass on the seventh day that the child died. And the servants of David feared to tell him that the child was dead, for they said, behold, while the child was yet alive, we spake unto him, and he would not hearken unto our voice. How will he then vex himself if we tell him that the child is dead? But when David saw that his servants whispered, David perceived that the child was dead. Therefore David said unto his servants, is the child dead? And they said, he is dead. Then David arose from the earth and washed and anointed himself and changed his apparel and came into the house of the Lord and worshipped. Then he came to his own house, and when he required, they set bread before him, and he did eat. Then said his servants unto him, what thing is this that thou hast done? Thou didst fast and weep for the child while it was alive, but when the child was dead, thou didst rise and eat bread. And he said, while the child was yet alive, I fasted and wept. For I said, who can tell whether God will be gracious to me, that the child may live? But now he is dead, wherefore should I fast? Can I bring him back again? I shall go to him. And this is the key point in this passage here. I shall go to him, but he shall not return to me. And David comforted Bathsheba his wife and went unto her, and lay with her, and she bare a son, and he called his name Solomon, and the Lord loved him. Now, this is the passage that we really go to show that babies go to heaven, because David, in the Old Testament, had an understanding that when he lost a baby, that that baby would be in heaven, because David is saying here in verse 23, it says, I shall go to him. And we know David was saved. David, when he died, would have gone to heaven. And David here had the understanding that when his baby died, would be in heaven, because David's saying, I'm going to go to him where the baby is, but he cannot return to me. He will not come back to life. So that is where we get the understanding of babies going to heaven. And it's a very comforting thought, because people have lost babies through miscarriages. People have lost babies through accidents or whatnot. And if we go by this doctrine of the Catholic Church of original sin, where in the guilt is inherited, how do you explain how a baby goes to heaven? Because, you know, if a baby is a guilty sinner, it deserves hell, why do they get pardoned and somebody who does not believe on the Lord Jesus Christ doesn't? And we'll go through that in a moment. But just a couple of thoughts on this passage. So we see here that David had the understanding that whilst it was tragic for the baby to die, he would see the baby again in heaven. Now, another point I just wanted to bring up in this passage, you can see here that losing the baby was an undesired consequence of his action. I don't actually think it was a punishment for his sin, and I'll go into that a bit later, but you can see that God actually put away his sin. So it wouldn't make sense for God to then punish David for his sin if God had put away his sin, in my eyes. So to me, I think it's more so because God didn't want an illegitimate child to be one of David's children, you know, because he was born of adultery, as opposed to just born of another wife, you know, another unmarried wife or one of his concubines. I think that's what it's more about. We see there in verse 14, you know, because by this deed thou hast given great occasion to the enemies of the Lord to blaspheme, the child also that is born unto thee shall surely die. So I think it was another reason God took the life of that child. But the point I wanted to make here is just, you see how it was an undesired consequence of his action, meaning, you know, David did not want to lose the child, but for whatever reason God had, God took the child from him. And the point I just want to make there is, you know, it's sad that today that people willingly do not want children. You know, whereas David, it was sad for a child to be taken from him, and yet we live in a day and age where people willingly do not want children, and it just shows how our values have changed. You know, our values have changed from wanting lots of children to being sad to the point he's fasting and not even wanting to eat to save the life of this child, and yet people nowadays don't want children at all. So I just think, you know, it's sad how far we've strayed from the values of God's word.